Hi, you have found Rides with Chuck. In this video, we go back to the World of Wheels car show and look at it from another angle. World famous customizer Gene Winfield was at the show to hold a class on top chopping. VooDoo Larry and his group did the heavy lifting, and I was lucky to talk to both Gene and Larry.
First of all, my name is Gene Winfield. I'm in Mojave, California, and I've been doing this over 70 years. My first shop was in late 46 in Modesto, California. So I'm just having a fun time.
You look like a kid.
I am. I'm just getting started.
Where do you see customizing like this heading into the future?
I think it's going up. See, it kind of leveled off for a while. The hot rodding and street rodding thing has been going uphill for a number of years, you know, just like crazy. And some of the older guys that wanted a custom car when they were in school, maybe high school, you know, they couldn't afford it. So now they can afford it. So now it's gaining popularity as we speak. It's just going uphill.
Who's the young customizer we should be watching, or a couple of them?
Well, there's several. There's all kinds of good guys that are doing tremendous work. You know, Troy Chapranga and I can't think of anybody right now, but you know, there's just lots of them that they're taking the old school shapes and they're using it with modern technology. You know, the modern welders and the things that we have today.
VooDoo Larry is one of those guys that's doing the same kind of auto body modifications as Gene Winfield, but with a more 2016 touch. I spoke with Larry at his shop to find out what it is like to work with a customizing legend.
Every year at World of Wheels, I do the Motorama section of the World of Wheels, which is the old school hot rods, customs, traditional set. I think my first chop I did with Gene back in 2010 out in Salina, we chopped a 54 Chevy. And ever since then, you know, Gene talk and we've contacted each other about chopping the top. And then all of a sudden one day the World of Wheels board decided they want to do a chop section with Gene. So it was cool to actually bring him in. So he comes in anyway. And since I do what I do here and he does what he does there, might as well take both talents and put us together to chop a top. You know, like I said, it's different because he also is the old school. He does everything that's 60 years ago, whereas I'm doing everything modern nowadays. So we take both of our talents and put them together. I've chopped about 70 cars myself. I'm sure he's probably chopped 170 cars, but everything's different. Everybody, two people that work together in the chop, it's kind of hard, but you know, it's cool because I'm learning with him and he's showing me what he does and I show him what I do, you know. So it's kind of nice to actually work with one of the forefathers of customizing, you know.
I used to go to World of Wheels back in 61, 62.
Yep.
You had cars there?
Yes. Well, yeah, see, the car that I went nationwide with, it actually was in 1960. It was called the Jade Idol. See, now I built it in 59 and finished it in 60, and it went all the way to New York and from California and hit all the major shows. And that kind of helped put me on the map, so to speak, because it was just a radical car. It was a 56 Merc, but sectioned 4 inches, wasn't chopped, but it was just a radical car and radical front and back and everything and the upholstery, and it had a television set in it and a telephone and everything, you know, back in 60. Well, I have a new book out that is all on movie cars, television, and commercials. When you see a commercial, there's no credits, so nobody knows who did a commercial. And I did a lot of crazy car commercials in the 70s and stuff like that. So
I'm going to buy your book before I leave.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
All right, done deal?
Thank you, done deal, yes. Thank you very much.
Oh, you're very welcome.